Now, what happened back in the day with you in French Montana? Because I know you had a couple of videos where you explained that situation. And did you guys ever see eye to eye or speak after that situation?
Nah, we haven't spoke. I haven't seen them or none of that. But listen, man, everybody's always got somebody, some love for. Just know, man, listen, man, a lot of times I leave a lot of shit alone. And it's because I have love for somebody else that got love for them. You feel me?
Yeah.
Other than that, it's like a lot of these guys and shit change up. You know what I'm saying? But I don't have nothing against French. Yeah, he got me kind of like a little bit disappoint me, yeah. But I still haven't seen him. We haven't really vibed and shit like that. I ain't got nothing against him and shit like that. I'm happy that he's doing his thing. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it's all blessing, man. He's from down the block from my hood.
Yeah.
For those that don't understand or don't know, French is from down the block on the other projects down the block from Cypress. You know what I'm saying? French Montana also interviewed me. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? For those that don't know that either. When he did that cocaine or whatever that shit was, Cocaine City or whatever.
Yeah.
Right? The DVD, you know, he was heavy on that DVD and all that.
Yeah.
I took him to my block, showed him the bullet holes. Vents, this, that, you know what I'm saying? Like, French, my little man and shit, man. Like, you know, we ain't just like, you know, it just ain't. I was just kind of disappointed because, you know, these guys, a lot of guys, they move different. They start getting to this, you know, they get caked up, they get all crazy like that, and they just like, they think they're never gonna see you or not like that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And them having money and all that don't make you real, or you know what I'm saying? Like, all that shit don't make you real, dog. These niggas got the game fucked up. These niggas think that you get caked up, now you Al Pacino or some shit. Now you fucking, you know, Al Capone or some shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And them, you know, like not realizing there's a lot of repercussions, bro. You strike, there's a lot of repercussions when you deal with a real one. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's different when it's a game, when it's industry shit. When it's real. And it's, you know, nah, it's different. You know what I'm saying? So, but listen, man, like I said, man, I give and I haven't talked to French because I just haven't made it my day. It's not imperative, brothers. Gotcha. You know what I'm saying? It's easy to find him. He's in LA. Like, it's easy. Like I told you, I run around and whatever. If you not cool with me, then you not safe in a lot of places. So you run around, y'all niggas do whatever y'all want on the other side of the world because I allow it. On G shit, because I'll be like, yo, what's up? What's up with that pussy? Is he still good? Is he alright or what? Nah, he's not. He alright.
Mm.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Let's keep it moving.
Did you know Chink Drugs?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had a lot of love for him, man. He's a good kid. He came to one of my birthday parties in New York.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Nah, he showed love and all that. He was street kid, man. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, when you're a real street guy and all that shit, man, a lot of shit don't really change. You still manage to overshow the streets love and all that and come out and come out. I didn't know him like that. He came to my birthday party, showed super love. I mean, appreciate that shit. You know what I'm saying? I had superstars come to my birthday party, but him coming to my party, shit was good. That shit was good money.
Well,
I appreciated that. You ain't got to be big and a superstar to come to my party. Fuck that.
You think rappers in the media today?